YouTube, back at it again. Next movie I'm gonna be talking about. Wait, first of all, like and subscribe. As you know, need them subs, need them likes, I need them views. You know, to feel wanted in this world. You know, I need to connect. Joking. Such an interesting idea. That's the first note I wrote for this movie. Crap, I haven't even said the name of the movie. It's Downsizing, but you probably saw it by the thumbnail. Anyway, and the title. Downsizing, it was an interesting movie. It was nice to see Matt Damon play a regular dude. Cause even in that George Clooney movie, I forgot what it's called, but he played such a messed up person in that movie. But it was an interesting idea and they ran with it. Like at least for the first two acts, they ran with the idea of downsizing and how it's important for the environment. Even at the end, they kind of went for the environment angle, which was interesting. Like from a creative standpoint, it was a mind-bending idea. Like, whoa, somebody actually thought about this, did their research, and you know, it got me intrigued about the idea. Like, yo, could this be a viable option for population? Warming and all these other things affecting us now, because you can't even tell by the lighting that it's cold as hell. Like it's like 1 to 2 p.m. there and it's already kind of dark. Another note I wrote is how savage his wife's decision was. That was so savage, and how she made it about her and blaming him for making it about her. And the fact that they both kind of went for it for the money, in a sense, to be comfortable, because they haven't been. Because that movie kind of jumps you from year to year to year and shows you the constant of their lives. Like, he was basically taking care of his mother, taking care of his wife. Then years later, taking care of somebody else. He was a carer. That's why he wanted to be a doctor, I guess. But he wasn't satisfied, you know? And his wife's decision was so savage, though. The fact that she let him go through it, that's the most savage thing. Like, they were both going through the same thing at the same time, basically. And she basically just left and thought, let him go on, then divorced them a year later. The time jumps were a little too much at some point, I won't lie to you. The pacing was just off. It's like, goddamn, already like, what, 17 years into the story? I was like, oh, it was like still an hour into the movie and more like 17 years into these people's lives. It was like too much. It's like the pacing problem was just as big, it was real. I'm gonna watch that movie again. Probably do another review, like a full one, because the other review was just my thoughts. Anyway. And her decision made his time in the downsizing place so fucked up, honestly, because he didn't really enjoy it anymore, because he made that deal to be comfortable, to enjoy life, to start spending, to, you know, to just to be right. And in the end, his time ended up being so lonely. He was alone for basically a year, started dating the single mother who basically told him off and he just walked away. That was funny as hell, I would lie to you. That was funny. Like I said, another note, the skip of time, like, it was too much. I think I've made my point about it. And the downsizing poor people. I was thinking, damn, how poor were you in the, like, real life until they started explaining where they're from. Like, they were prisoners and whatnot, refugees and all that stuff. Poor people were just sad, yo. Like, even the downsizing place where basically 100,000 is 12 million. You still have the most poorest people ever. With fucking robotic legs and all that shit. Oh, that was just another situation. And the leg and his love interest. It was just a direction I did not expect. Honestly, the story from like the end of the second act to the third act went totally sideways for me. I was like, what the hell am I watching? Did not anticipate anything that happened from the moment from the single mother moment where he went to the party, he went lit, and he started doing the doctor thing a little, broke the woman's leg, then started helping the woman, then he had to go to Norway, and he started loving the woman, and she was so vulgar, yo. And so many accents started popping up from the third act, like so many, like everybody had this unique different accent from point trying their best to speak English. Just trying to make it universal, since English is the universal language, I guess, in a sense, because we speak it here and a lot of people speak it everywhere. But you know what I'm saying. Like, I think that was my last note, actually. The accents were, the ending wasn't satisfactory. As, like I said in my previous review, in The Vanishing of Sydney Hill, it's a movie I'll go back to and watch over and over again. This movie, I'm fine. Like, I gave this movie like a 7. It was entertaining, it was funny, it had an interesting idea. All the actors were on par, they delivered, they had a great time doing what they were doing. They went with it, like I said, they had an interesting idea and they ran with it. You know what I'm saying? But it's a 7. It's not something I would rave to people about. I'll rave to my artsy-fartsy friends who want to see the idea aspect of it. I already told some of my friends to go check it out, but I wouldn't recommend it to a stranger. Or would I? Go watch it. If you are artsy-fartsy, idealistic type of person. But it wasn't satisfactory for me at the end. And this is a spoiler review, so you should have watched it before watching this video, by the way. Anyway, thank you. Like and subscribe. Hope you enjoy my reviews. Join the family, you know what I'm saying? 23 year old dude trying to share my opinion on an art form I truly love. So, thank you. Doses.